OMG. Sit back, relax, and sip your tea. We keep you company. Like, first of all, this heat is
crazy, man.
I feel like I'm going to be looking so shiny in all our latest videos because I just can't wear makeup in this heat right now. It's actually horrible.
And this heat is affecting productivity a lot. Like, but we just have to keep pushing through, man. So that's first of all. Then second of all, disclaimer. Our games video that's coming up on Friday, the intro will sound like they just got back from the UK. But that intro is supposed to be for the intro for this. But we thought we were going to put that out first last Friday, but we just decided that, okay, since we're starting to clean slate, let's start this Monday.
Okay.
So in case we start that one, the way we are going to start this one now, just please understand. So the way we are starting it is, hey, how you guys, how you doing? Longest time, man.
It's been ages.
Yeah, I know you guys, it will sound somehow when we say longest time, because you're like, should we still see your sort of video? Like, but the thing is, they've been in the UK vacating or whatever. Mm. UK is not really a vacation place like that, yeah.
No, it doesn't matter.
Mm. So they've been there for like a month.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been here in the sun hustling, changing naira to pounds and sending.
You don't hustle, babe.
We don't hustle. It's okay. Yeah, we thank the Lord.
Amen.
But they're back. Yeah. But you guys, you didn't notice that because we're faithfuls in the sense that we had recorded a lot of episodes, so we're just putting them out and everything. Anyways, I'm sure you've seen our introduction video and you know what we're all about. So today's Monday, and let's get things started.
Let's get pushing.
So yeah, today I want to talk about how it was when you traveled.
How was it for you?
Man. Anyways, first off, what the first thing I would like to say is I think time away from each other is actually healthy in marriage. I think it makes you, because see, all of us we are prone to take each other for granted. If we're just in each other's faces. So it's good. I don't want her to leave my space. I missed her and everything. But her being away made me actually realize how much I might have been taking her for granted. So I think the following ways are the sides of you I've been taking for granted. I did not know.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that you cook for me. Man, babe, I appreciate it so much. I didn't suffer, but I didn't enjoy it. I can cook, yeah, but it's not the same thing because
you can cook, won't cook.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, and the fact that you go to the kitchen every time, and the fact that you take your time and you try to be creative.
Different dishes.
Like, my talk has been, before she met me, is always rice and noodles, because I'm like, what is there? What else is there to eat? But she has made it a life mission.
Yeah.
To make sure she distracts my attention from rice and creates other things. But I really, really appreciate that. And I knew what it meant, like going to the kitchen morning, afternoon, evening, every day. Now I appreciate that. There's no beans. Now why don't they make beans? Then, that's one. Then number two, father, I don't just like the house was just so empty, and it now made me realize that I don't look at you enough.
Oh.
Let me look at you right now. Look at me. Look at me, seriously. What's that? What does it really look at each other?
That's true. You know, like when life is happening so fast, didn't even look at each other.
See how it feels.
I remember you used to look at me like this when we were dating.
You started again.
Have changed.
But yeah, think about it. When, like, do you really make eye contact with your wife or your spouse? Do you take your time to look at them? As you are watching this video now, if they are beside you, just look at them.
Do you know what? He used to, I used to catch him watching me when we were dating. And early, like maybe like first year in our marriage, but now get heading to the third year. I have to be like, babe, look at me. Look at me.
But I've realized that now, and I'm going to be looking at you more. Like for the rest of this video, I'm like really going to be looking at you.
It's okay,
but I'm sure you guys realized, like, just like if you look at your wife or your husband, just look at them now. Like, just look. You notice that, like, you don't even know them in the sense that they are features you have not even noticed. Do you understand? Like,
very handsome.
Do you understand? See your eyes. Like, for example, see this pupil inside. What's the pupil? Is the black or the white one? The black one is the pupil. Yeah. Then there's another student inside the pupil.
The cornea.
And I was studying all this in school. The tiny one inside the black one is the cornea.
The little one is cornea.
The white one is what?
The white one is
yolk.
The eyeball. The little eyeball, isn't it? I don't know.
Is the black one the pupil? And I used to draw this in biology.
It's actually, and the thing is,
teachers, you wasted our time in school.
No one's eyes are actually black. They're actually very dark brown. That's what we learned. And the rims.
Yeah, I can see it's dark now. Yeah.
Everyone, no one has black pupils. And then if you look it up, you'll see like the outside of the pupil. You'll like it's like a normal like a blue or something.
Oh yeah. Open now. I'm looking at you. Anyways, missed you, man. I missed you.
I missed you too.
It was 4 months. It wasn't easy, man.
4 months?
One month. Sorry. It felt like 4 months.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, you were just enjoying now.
Oh, well. On the contrary, my friend. To be fair, like, every time I go back to London, it's like going home. Although home is Nigeria, but home is London. I always feel like I'm stuck between two places because they're both home. And it's always refreshing to go back after being here for such a long stretch. And especially the heat, when the heat is just another level, and then you go there, actually it was quite cold. I like it when it's like spring weather or like summer there, because it's not quite the same as our heat, but it was cold. It was meant to be spring, it was raining, that's what they call it, April showers and then May flowers. So right now it's actually quite sunny, but when we were there it was a bit chilly and I wasn't really enjoying that too much, and it was raining a lot. And you know, it's always lovely to see like my sisters and my mum, my parents and everything. So it's always wonderful to see them and all my friends. It's always great to see them and hang out. But man, London is expensive. It's so expensive.
Like, you see how I didn't come into the picture in order to talk.
It's so expensive.
Friends.
You're not in London. So.
But this talk is about.
Yeah, wait. Let me.
The impact on each other.
Can I land? So dramatic. Anyway, so you know, you were saying that I enjoy it. And I was like, yes, these are the parts that I enjoy. But whilst I was there, you know, I really missed my husband, my darling husband, because not because you're telling me to, but because especially with Fermi, like, you know, there were certain times when I would get on the bus and I realized I haven't taken him for granted, because he is very firm with Fermi. I feel like I'm firm, but he's firmer. And sometimes she knows that. So like she did that. You know when you're out and they just completely do one dramatic tantrum. So we were on the bus. I had biscuit. I gave her biscuit. I gave her, like, there's only a little bit left. I gave it to her, and it finished. That's how my daughter started crying. So I was like, Fermi, no, it's finished. She's like, and there's all draw. And I was like, and the bus was packed. So the embarrassment was creeping up on me. And I knew at that point in time that if Fermi's dad was here, he'd be like, Fermi, stop. And she was, I told her stop. She didn't want to hear a word. And that happened on different occasions. And I realized how much I took. And there's many times that I've said that, oh, you know, maybe babe, you're being too hard on her. But I actually realized that I needed his partnership. I needed his firmer hand.
No, why? You're not still letting me be stern with her.
I do allow you to be stern with her. That's what I'm saying. That I feel.
And I just jumped.
Can I just finish? Junction. Where are we going?
I think it's a junction.
It should be junction though.
No, juncture, babe.
Yeah, only. But what juncture? Where are we going?
You grew up in London. You don't even hear English.
Anyway, so like for me, I see that I took his firmness for granted. And I can understand more why sometimes the benefit of us being different in the way we deal with her as well. So, and I really, really do appreciate how you are with her. And I really do make my best efforts not to be involved when you're trying to let her know. And that's why it pains me when you feel like I'm not, but I really am. And I need you to meet me halfway. So that, and also just having like big cuddles with my, and I'm not talking about sex here, because, you know, I'll leave it to a guy here. But like just big hugs and just, I miss talking to you. We're talking on FaceTime and stuff, but it's different. Like sometimes you're just in the house with you, just, and I'm like, babe, oh my gosh, this and that. Just be talking. And I'll kiss him. Kissing, waking up next to him in the morning. I really miss that. Like rolling over, it was my sweet fairy, but it's not the same. You know, she could give me a big kiss. It was cute, but it's really not the same.
That talking to me that you just described now, is not talking to me. You say you miss gisting me because you be the one talking and I'll just be listening.
And you just be listening. But like, you know, he's always very attentive in that way. And I miss that. I missed you.
Wow. Anyway, so let's just touch that angle a little bit. We don't want to talk too much today.
Yeah.
But the training the child angle, yeah?
Yeah. No, we're still talking about London, though.
Okay, we're still talking.
Yeah.
And like, I will finish now.
So we talk about the fact that, okay, and I can also agree with the fact that, yes, time away is refreshing. I feel like it does refresh us in our relationship, in our marriage, and it does allow us to appreciate one another a lot more.
Because I was going to say it didn't refresh me, but the way you now put it, yeah, it's refreshing that way. Because personally, it didn't refresh anything. It was, maybe if Nigeria was, it was better, like if they brought light more, you know, if I don't have to just be spending too much on fuel, and the gen itself will not carry the AC well, although it's a big gen, and if the sun was not...
Actually, let me rephrase what I said. London is a holiday. When you're anywhere that you're leaving Nigeria, it's
anyway,
a holiday.
Yeah. In fact, at this stage, Kenya is even
Kenya is
such
amazing.
A holiday.
Let's not even
Mali, put it. I don't want to say Libya because I don't want to bring the Libya issue small.
Libya was actually I don't know about now, but from what I've
but
I've
Libya
heard,
normal
very wonderful.
Libya like legitimately through the normal route is it anywhere away from Nigeria right now is a holiday, but God will help us.
We will be restored. Amen.
Do you understand?
Amen.
But yeah, I just want to touch the child part slightly a little bit. Like, you are anti-stern, you are anti-harsh, you know, you are left to me, said by now, I would have been not necessarily spanking, but
you would have been spanking her.
No, not spanking, beating, but I would have been touching her to let her know that what she's like, this thing you did is wrong and everything, blah, blah, blah. But you are always. As in,
do you know, I'm not anti those things. I'm anti not, like, I just don't, like, I've said it before on this channel, I think we've touched on, like, you know, raising up a child and stuff, and I don't want to go too much into it. I'm just anti a lot of things that, for me, is very cultural. And, like, for example, like, saying something like, a child is crying for no reason, for me, I don't think it's beneficial. My English is really not working right now.
But
I just think it's not helpful, because there is always something that a child is crying for, whether it's something that is important or is less important, of less importance. There is still something, and it's, for me, I'm always trying to figure out what it is. So now I can then distinguish whether it's like, okay, you need to sit down there and have that, or whatever. I feel like I'm just trying to communicate better with her so that she can communicate. I learned something whilst I was there, was when we were out with like my friends and their children, that Fermi would, like, you know, when someone would touch it, she would scream a lot. I thought before we went that it was just normal. Like, I thought it was just part of what they do. Yeah, that's how she is. But then what I realized was, she was, one of my friends said to me that, okay, you need to tell her to give her a word, give her words, tell her to use her words. And I noticed one of my other friends doing that with her daughter, use your words. Because at that point, she's trying to, she's frustrated at whatever, and out of the frustration is her screaming, right? So she, rather than her screaming or crying, she needs to express herself, and I need to, but she doesn't know how to, so I have to give her the words to say.
Then don't have any issues with that.
I know. So that for me is what I'm trying to get right, is to communication with her, to balance that with the punishment. That, do you understand? As opposed to it being a thing of straight away it's punishment and then discovering what happened after.
That nobody's saying that, mm-hmm. but from my angle, there's no punishment you are balancing anything with. Do you get? Like, you are the sweet cup. You are always, and that is what I'm always like, okay, it shouldn't kind of like be this way, in the sense that I don't think you should be friends with your child every time. Do you understand?
I don't think you should be friends with your child at all.
No, you should be friends with your child.
Can't be friends. Are you friends?
Friends. You're the mom. Be friend. No, you know what I mean. Like, don't do linguisticism.
No, that's normally an ongoing debate. People talk about it as well. Like, you know, some people, they believe that you can be friends with
her. I want to be friends with her. Like, I want to be her friend at the same time as her dad. Like, you have a lot of things in her life, you get. If, like, actually friend. Because you have other people that you are friends with, it doesn't mean that you are at the same level and everything.
Okay.
I want that friendly relationship, definitely, but you can't be a friend every time. I want her to know that there's this scary side of me that can be activated by doing some things. And over time, it will now lead to knowing that these things are activating those things, those sides of me, because
absolutely.
These things you are doing are bad. Do you understand?
Yeah, absolutely.
And there's nothing wrong with, like, I have a problem with, once in a while, if she does something wrong, okay, maybe you just need to explain. But yeah, there are some, once in a while, like, you'd be like, stop, no, don't do that. You get, like, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Like,
I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. I'm saying that because she's still at a stage where everything she's picking up, she's basically like a sponge. Every little, you know, every single word that you say, stop, no, don't do that, it's fine. But I'm just saying that sometimes you have to explain because
you have to explain every time.
You have to explain because it's to express, so that she'll be able to express
that.
You
have to explain every time.
Yeah.
But the fact that you have to explain every time does not mean it's every time you have to tell her off softly.
No,
sometimes
okay.
you have to be very harsh with the way you tell her off, then you explain. Do you understand?
Let me take it from this angle. Whilst I was away, there was, like, you know, I had to do that. Do you understand? I was doing that. And if I wasn't doing that, then it would have been evident how she was behaving. I was the one that would tell her off. So it's not like I don't have it in me, but whenever we're home, you're the one that assumes that role anyway. So I never need to. That's essentially it.
Okay, do you remember a typical, like, what's the most telling off you did when you were, like, what was?
I can't remember, I did a lot. Because
like, just think of one. Like, what do you think was the harshest you were with her?
I don't know.
I'm not.
Because for me, it's like, it's not about how harsh I can be. I don't think I need to be harsh at all. I think I can be stern without being harsh. I think that if I'm telling her something and she's aware, because she's already crying when I'm telling her, Femi, do not touch that. Do not go there. Maybe I may not sound like you.
It's not the sound.
It sounds weak in comparison to you.
No, I'm not even saying you are weak or anything. What I'm saying is, like, the end result of what I'm looking at is, like, what I'm trying to get at is the effect it's having on her.
Do
you understand?
Yeah,
like,
absolutely. And I see it.
For instance, this bus situation you talked about.
Yeah.
Like, if I was there, you said once I say stop, she will stop.
She will stop crying, right?
You get, but you had to take.
I said, like, once or twice, I'd say like twice or three times.
I know, like, it's
like,
cool.
Fermi, it's enough. And now, like now, I've learned the whole, Fermi, it's enough. You can have this when this happens. Do you understand? As opposed to,
I'm not even questioning your styles or anything.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is, okay, there is the whole, there are two different ways to look at it. There's the whole, okay, yeah, I can run to my mom for comfort.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
But there's another rule, there's another, oh yeah, she can't do anything anyways.
No,
do you understand?
She doesn't have that.
And that is what that's what I'm just trying to avoid.
She doesn't have that with me. In the, like, I don't feel like she has that with me at all. And I think that, you know, again,
because there are times that I tell her not to do stuff. If it was just me and her, then she won't do it. But once you come, once you get there, she
sometimes, she does that with me when I tell her not to do something and you come and she does it again. So it's like, she has to test who will, like, it's like she wants to see what you will say. at the end of the day, it's all about, they want to continuously push boundaries. And if I don't back you up and say that, no, you don't do that, then that's a different thing entirely. If I'm allowing her to do it, then I feel like that's something else entirely. But I'm not allowing her to do it. I feel like, maybe it's not a critique, I'm not sure, but I feel like it's your the way you view how you are, it's fine. And I've accepted it. And I actually appreciate it. And the way I do it, I feel like it's also fine. And I feel
I'm not saying it's not fine. That's why I said from the onset, it's not about how you do anything.
Yes.
It's about some things that you say, like some things that you write off totally that I feel like, okay, you probably should not write
like
off.
Smacking.
Do you understand? I wrote off smacking because of you.
Okay, but you would.
I don't know. Normally, I would have, but yeah, because I saw reason with you.
Okay.
I wrote it off and everything. That, okay, yeah, it's not. Thank God. It might be necessary, but thank God. There are some. Because of how far, it's only how far we see that we can.
To be honest.
Do you understand? We just thank God for the kind of child she is and everything.
To be honest, I've smacked her on the hand a few times.
She's not even the kind of child that. Because she actually listens. But why I said, I wrote off smacking because I don't like. I reasoned with you, then there's really no reason. But there are some children that,
absolutely.
Like for example, me, if I wasn't spanked,
I say this because, do you know why I say this? And I think we're going back to it. It's because, it's how you start how you mean to go off, innit?
You say what?
You start how you mean to continue. Like from early, normally, like in my household anyway, we were smacked from a very early age anyway. Whether it's like a smack on the bottom, it's a gradual thing. So you would see it as.
And I think another like why you are so anti-smacking, which smacking is not even the discussion now. I understand, but why you are so totally anti-smacking that nobody should be smacked at all is maybe the manner you said you were being smacked. Like you don't even know what you did.
Yeah.
Do you understand? But there are professionals that actually they are correctional. Smacking is correctional. There are some people there are some children that maybe in their whole lifetime they were not smacked more than twice, but maybe those two smackings
was enough for them.
Maybe without those two smackings,
Do you know what? I'm not even trying to write off what you're saying. It's not even just because of what my experience is. Because when I worked in the school, I couldn't smack the children that were rude to me. I had to find a different technique, and because I learned that different technique, and I learned a way to speak to them that really affected them. I realized I don't need to touch a child in order for me to express my disappointment with them. It may mean that, okay, that smacking, right? It may have more of a lasting effect in terms of you don't have to talk much. You just have to just smack them once.
And for example, in my primary school, I know some very stubborn students that if there was no cane factor, they would have turned out worse in the sense that there was a time a teacher we had that she did not like she was cane that you can do anything without cane. Do you understand? And at this rate, people were not really turning in assignment because at the end of the day, she shall not beat me and everything. Yeah. Then when they now changed to one Uncle Grant, Uncle Grant, you are still alive, bros. Damn, as in Uncle Grant. When that man came, everything changed. Yeah, we were living in fear, but it wasn't fear as to I don't know how to put it. It was a lot correctional. Like even the classed out had to be doing the assignments, and it ended up being better academically. Do you understand?
I understand that's what I'm
saying. In as much as I agree that smacking might be overrated, but not in all cases. There might be some rare cases that smacking just needs to be.
I think we're going to agree to disagree because I say this because I've seen children that are like, oh my god, you can. Inner city kids, people that know inner city children, some of them like in Hackney, not saying anything about Hackney people, but inner city children in Hackney, I was working in a public school, in a state school, and it was an academy. Academies are normally schools that have been basically reformed because they were so bad before they had to reform it and turn it into an academy. And the kind of children that we had in that school, I can't even talk. The way they used to talk, and I'm saying that because you can actually, because a lot of the time it's not about what you're doing, it's about how you communicate with them. Smacking is a form of communication, mind you, but then for me, I believe it's a negative one because it's not teaching them anything. And for that moment, all they can feel is pain, especially with young children. all they can feel is pain, right? And it's like, they know that I shouldn't do this because pain. That's it.
So let's be meeting ourselves halfway, like, so to make more sense. You believe it's not doing anything, which I want to kind of disagree
that's
with.
What I believe it's counterproductive. That's what I believe it's counterproductive. I think that if, for example, now, if you teach a child, a young child, okay, someone like Fermi now, I smack her, right? And then she goes to school, God forbid, but she smacks another child.
Like, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's not just smacking for the sake of smacking.
No, but it happens.
See, sometimes, you know, smacking is not necessary. Yeah. Like, and you let it go, it's not necessary. But sometimes, I don't want to get full Bible in this thing at all. Do you understand? But the same Bible said, train a child in the way it should go. When it goes up, it would not depart from it. That means training. That means you can use mouth to train and train them the way you want them to be. Mm-hmm. But the same Bible also says, spare the rod and spoil the child.
But it's proverbial as well.
Share my point. My point, which I'm making, is the fact that I don't think there's a right and wrong way to train a child. I think each children are unique. And it's the job of the parents to see the uniqueness of the child and to know the best way to know the best way to be able to train and relate with that child. Like, you, it's your job from when you give birth to them to just be extremely sensitive as to the best way to communicate with them. Do you understand?
When I think about it, most of the things that I was smacked for, my mom even says it now. She doesn't smack. She barely smacked my sisters. She said that, oh, it was because I was the first. They were learning. Like, and again, you know, I'm yet to meet somebody, unless they're very, you know, like, I don't know. I just feel like, again, with smacking, it's something that there's always another option. I'm not trying to tell anyone how to raise their children, but I'm just saying in terms of, like, you know, maybe I might start doing a course on child psychology, because for me, I feel like it goes a lot deeper than people realize. And like you said, train a child in the way that they should go. From the beginning, when you train a child in a certain way, and, you know, there's a certain expectation that you have of them, and there's certain rules that they have to follow, and there's a certain way that you do things, then I feel like that's enough for them to understand without you having to go out of yourself.
There are sometimes
and you use that energy.
See, okay, paint this picture. There are sometimes you might need to go out of yourself. Like, there are just some extreme times that you might just need to take extreme measures. Now, spanking does not mean... When I say spanking, it doesn't mean it should be habitual. Like, whenever your child does something wrong, you should just go and get a cane and spank. In this picture, like, okay, you've been the nice guy with your child and you've been stern. You've been saying, okay, don't do this, don't do that, blah, 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 blah. And cane has never been the issue. You've been this sweet, but something extreme happens one time and this person just brings cane to cane you. Do you understand? Like, you know, it's not regular. Do you understand? And again, it's how you do it that matters. Do you understand? Like, you don't just cane and just let go. Like, you cane and talk. Everything is strategic. That's what I'm just going to get back to. Now, I'm not saying every child should be caned. I'm not even saying caning is the way to go. I agree with you that there are better ways to deal with things. But I'm just saying that caning should not be written off totally. It should just be done strategically. Just make sure you know what you are doing. You understand? As I see myself now, God help us and everything. But I don't see myself beating her. I don't see myself killing her for any reason. You understand? I'm just saying it should not. It's like,
for me,
I'm not of the school of thought that is it should be written off. It should not be part of parenting.
I think, like,
there's a way you can cane your child that should be child abuse, but there's a way you can cane your child that is.
Who are we to distinguish that? Sometimes when you're so angry that you don't even know, and I think nobody is perfect.
That's what I'm saying. How you do it matters.
Rather than don't allow yourself,
don't cane as a result of anger.
But that's it should thing, be most deliberate. Times it is as a result of anger.
That's a different. See, you are bringing another.
Yes,
we are not saying.
Why would I plan to spank my child when I could just plan for their punishment? This is the punishment that you're going to receive.
There are times that does not now make the difference.
I'm saying to you that that's not true. That's not the case. That means, like, unless we've exhausted every other option, then, like,
and it's which, possible
it's
to
not, have... it's not. It's not.
Okay,
I
so
don't
guys,
agree.
What do you guys think
we
about?
Don't, we don't agree on this.
What do you guys think about? And that's what parenting is majorly, because it's two people that see different things, like, comes from two different areas of life, bringing up a child. So no matter what, no matter how in disagreement you guys are, you always have to share a rich agreement for the sake of the champ. Hence, why from the onset now already, okay, yes, we are not beating. Although, it's because of the kind of child she is at that. Thank God, you understand? That's all I would just say, thank God. But what do you guys see? My school of thought is every child is unique. Deal with them accordingly, study your child very, very well and everything. I also agree that the way our parents did it then, I'm not saying our parents made a mistake and everything, but I think there was overuse of caning and flogging and everything because it was just the way. Once you do something wrong, okay, oh yeah, it's you that will even go and bring the cane yourself and everything. I disagree with that too. It shouldn't even be like, make I not do this, make it okay, because there's no punishment you can't get used to. It will now be like, I go fit take this cane. How many they will give me? Should it not be 12? Make I enjoy this thing. Do you understand? I disagree with that too. But what I'm saying is, I don't think it should be written off that a parent is not, because left to you, that means if you are in any position of power, you make the rule that no parent is allowed to flog their children.
Because do you know why? Sometimes,
and I don't think it should be written
with adults,
off. Let me just finish mine. Okay. So you now don't forget what you are going to say. So that is where I stand on this and everything. So you guys, we need you to drop your comments and let's read through your mind. So I've said where I stand. So say your mind. So this, you know, we just finished debate. So you are rounding up your.
So my round. So you know, my honourable people out there, I will say that again. The reason my stance on it is because I believe like we need to try and be as much in control as possible. As parents, we're not perfect. We're all learning. I'm learning continuously. And I have hit her in the hand like twice and I felt so bad. But at the same time.
What made you hit her on the hand?
Because it was frustration. Because she was doing something wrong and I was like, you don't touch that. And I hit on the hand. And it's like, and I didn't have to.
So what was the response? Like when you hit her on the hand, what happened?
She was crying, wasn't it? But it's the same cry that she cries when I tell her off. So it's the same exact reaction.
So why didn't you just tell her off as opposed
exactly,
to...
Exactly, because I was...
what made you frustrated? Because you kept on saying it and she wasn't doing what you were saying.
No, because it was what she did. Like the fact that she touched something that I can't remember, that she wasn't supposed to.
So
it wasn't a case of continuous. Like there are times of continuous. But it's more likely like what particular thing that she has done. But anyway, I've just taken my thing off.
Sorry.
But it's up to everybody what they do with their children. That's their business. My stance on it is just that unless you've exhausted every other option, smacking shouldn't really be in it. I think that it's counterproductive in so many ways, and I think that the reason why
I need to get out.
Let me finish.
But I need to get you straight through. You do understand? You say unless you've exhausted every area of option.
No, you know, okay. Let me ask. That was wrong.
Because no, I need me, to know. Okay. You are saying smacking should be written off.
Yeah, should be written off. Uh-huh. No, no. I don't believe that you can exhaust every other option. And I think that you know, in comparison to our parents, we have access to a lot more knowledge. And a lot more different things and a lot more help than we did back then. So I feel like there really isn't a necessity for smacking. And I think that, yeah, I think that, you know, people may not agree, it's fine. But at the end of the day, that's just my stance on that.
So help us, what do you think about this?
We've talked about this a lot already.
We've not. The video did not go out.
We did.
It did not.
I remember people reading comments.
There was a particular video which I did.
We mentioned it.
No, but we did a full video on this, but it didn't go out.
There was one video that we did and we mentioned it and people were commenting.
Mentioned, but we never really talked about it this much. Yeah. So we didn't talk about it like that.
But yeah.
But thank God that we don't have any reason to spank and everything. So cool.
Amen. May God bless us.
Amen. Because you understand. But yeah.
Wow. Well, yeah.
So should spanking be written off or not? What do you like? You know, you go where I was coming from. You go where she's coming from. Which I she's making a lot of sense to me. Like,
you're making sense as well.
Understand.
It's just that
slight part I don't really agree with. Like,
me too. I don't understand.
Yeah, because I'm sure there are some people that will even come out that if nobody say cane, they thank God for the cane and their parents. They know for day where they did.
People say that a lot, I don't agree with that. But you know, that's again.
You don't even agree with what people say for them themselves because they know themselves.
Because
so you are saying you know them better than the way they know themselves.
No, I'm just saying that it's by the grace of God. and they didn't turn out the way, not so, because of the cane.
What if it's the grace of God that inspired the canary? Like, what if you're like, okay, you need to cane him for
who
this
in,
one.
Okay, and so who, apart from slaves in the Bible, were caned?
Cain.
But it's a good, it's a good question. But,
like, that is to show you that caning your child is not really a major thing. That
exactly.
Wait. It's not a. It's normal. It's not like a major. Wait. It's not a major cause of discussion that you now put it in the Bible that, and David beat his son because his son did what he, you get.
I understand.
Do you understand?
But I understand. But what I'm trying to say
and
is
see,
that
see, God, see, okay. The fact that they use rod and child in the same sentence means see.
It's you translation, can't, babe. If you go back to the translation, the Bible. If you go back to the to the if you have like what was that was in Spedo, that was in the Spedo Old Testament.
I think it's in Proverbs somewhere. What's that?
Yeah. So you need to go back to the Hebrew, what rod is, and then find out what the actual word is, and then translate that word, and you'll probably find out that doesn't even mean a physical rod at all.
No. Bible cannot like be misleading.
I understand, but sometimes
so rod, in the rod of Moses that okay touch
in, sometimes in translation. I'm
Translations get you the words that are closest in meaning.
Exactly.
Do you understand?
But it may not mean that physically, that's what I'm trying to say. But anyway, we've got to go. Frame is awake.
My frame is awake, talking about the child. We are coming, you know. So thank you, drop your comment. Okay, yeah, there should be a random moment. So I will drop the video of the random moment of when I went to pick them up at the airport, and you'll see Fermi's reaction. So
awesome.
Yeah, take it. OMGs, OMGs. Ram. Did you miss me? Welcome home. You have missed. Okay, yeah. You have missed home. I see. See, I'm going everywhere. I see. Wow. Are you serious? Wow, you have missed all these things. So welcome back. So as you can see that it's not only us that missed each other. Feral himself missed home and everything, you know. Thank you for watching. We see you on Wednesday when we're having our special time with Feral. So like this video, share this video.
Subscribe.
If you are a new subscriber, please subscribe.
Hit the bell.
Notifications button. Thank you very much. Support us. We are thank you for 5,000 subscribers. But
thank
we can
you guys.
Help us build our channel.
All right, guys. Take care.
We love you. Bye.
Bye.